So I had a, okay, so one of our friends, he recommended for me to go down to
the station. Is it?
Yeah. Oh. And somehow I know him through, funnily enough, the Lee Hoffman. But he knows that I've been acting on stage, that I'm interested in performing. So he obviously thought that I had something in me that was psychotic enough to have been a natural casting choice. So I went for the audition and then I went through 2 rounds of callbacks. And then, so finally they said, okay, you got the part. Okay, I got the part. And at that point of time, I didn't really know what it meant. I was like, okay, cool, I get to be in the film. But it didn't sink in how big and juicy this role was going to be until we actually, I read the script, started shooting, and until it was done, and I saw my huge face on the screen. But it said to me that it was really, a really rare opportunity of a lifetime. Because my face is in virtually every other scene. It's a huge part to land for someone who's never been in a film before. So, the excitement was sort of only really reached a peak like after I was done with the show. It's kind of strange.
I think even today you can feel the excitement from you.
I get more excited, with every re-watching, the thing or re-launching it in DVD or when it premieres on new place. I think, slowly I'm starting to really feel like I really own this piece of work. So, yeah.
I think cinema can really bring you to places that you can never imagine, I'm sure.
But when,
then you come from a theatre background, a musical theatre background, and I'm sure there are huge differences between performing on stage putting your face on film. How does it work for you to transit from here to there?
I think the fundamentals in terms of acting, your motivation, things like understanding your character, all these are about the same. Going through track grid of the script, following an emotional arc through the script, all these are the same, but the actual process of performance is dramatically different. I was really glad that they were very patient during the shoot. Things like, from the very first day, I didn't know where I was supposed to look. Can you look into camera? Look at, keep your eye line. What is Conti?
Right.
Change the lens into a wide shot, mid shot, close up, okay, try really, try again, try one more time, things like that. I was like, oh my god. But because it was such an intensive schedule, I didn't have time to really worry about it too much. Just had to go there, okay, just do what the director tells you, do, and then, I was just glad, we managed to complete everything. So only in retrospect did I realize how much I had accumulated in terms of learning the whole process. And even right now to people, there are people in charge of, just like the art department, in charge of making sure that everything looked exactly the same as we did in the
previous show.
Making sure the light was exactly the same. Oh, we're losing light, just things like that you would never have to worry about in a more controlled environment of the theater, the stage. So, that was really fun. But another challenge was the emotional continuity. In theatre, the moment you step on the stage, there's no NGs, there's no reruns. But at least every emotional you accumulate from the beginning of the story takes you to the climax. Whereas for this, I had to find my own placement of where I was
for the scene.
So, I was lucky that my co-actor, Samo, was also from theatre, and he had already made this similar transition from stage to screen before I did. Okay. So he helped to guide me along. And then of course, Lynn was there to tell me, okay, I need you to do a little bit more of this, and the rest of this. And then so that helped me to find my grounding.
Just to interject, Samo, as you mentioned, is actually a co-partner on screen, Wu Zili from Taiwan. I've seen his work before. He's been in a couple of independent films, and I think he's one of the emerging new talents to watch out for. But he did his next manga type of blockbuster role. But it appears that Joanna is a very obedient actress, actor to work with, and she basically follows what the director say. Is that true? Okay, now it's time for Lillian to rebut.
She was awesome. And she says, claims that she was inexperienced. First day, she was a real pro. Very, very smart, very sharp. Yeah,
yeah.
Actress.
Mom was a good actress. She was like a consummate professional. And I also must thank Joanna's mom. Because Joe's mom was also really sweet and Joe does a lot of props. And also she was really generous at giving us things and you know, just very
always visiting the set.
Yeah, very, very easygoing about timings and everything that they needed from her. And she was really
very committed.
Yeah, really a committed actress, and as you can see, it has paid off beautifully because she won.
Joanna's efforts in forever brought her home the Star Hunter Award to Shanghai National Film Festival. They chose 10 the most promising young actors and actresses in the nation, and thousands of applicants. Wow, so you actually done Singapore proud?
Yeah,
outside China. Oh, okay. Wow.
Treatment. They put me up at the Waldorf Astoria, which is the Waldorf cellar is named after the Waldorf Astoria in New York, and then the Shanghai one is the sister branch. So it's a 6-star hotel, full star treatment. I walked the red carpet. It was very exciting, you know, rub shoulders with the who's who's, all these big names were there. The whole thing was quite overwhelming, but the long and short of it was I was really happy that I got an award because I was the oldest recipient of this new talent award. And I was eligible.
You are the oldest.
Because you are eligible if you have been the lead in less than 2 feature films. And obviously this was my first feature film, so I was eligible. But the rest, the youngest recipient, someone called Yu Mao from China, he's only 19. And then there's another recipient girl from Thailand who's already, he has a huge fan base, and he's been in a couple of hit idol, idol type movies. So
he's barely his early 20s.
Yeah. So I was just really really glad that I got to win something before my time was up and a newcomer.
Don't worry, you're still not launching your picture.
Yeah. It's okay, lad, but I'm not shy. I'm 20-30.
Never too late to get into film.
Yeah, exactly. I'm just really glad. I think this is not just a recognition for me as an actor, but just for the film and the quality, the production quality for the film. So yeah, please do have to be very, very excited to do that.
Yeah, Shanghai National Film Festival is really now one of the major film event, film festival to look out for in Asia, and I'm also very proud that we got this. I'm sure you have pictures from Shanghai that you can check out Facebook of Joanna Dong.
If you go to Facebook and you just search for Joanna Dong, or you search for Forever the Movie, you'll be able to find some photos and some links to articles regarding the Shanghai International
Film Festival. Cool. Okay, now moving on back on track to the film itself, the production of it.